In most cases, when you are designing wind power facilities, you're not going to just stop at one wind turbine. You're most likely going to design several wind turbines as a wind farm, because there are different criteria you use for one wind turbine and different when you use it for a wind farm. Hi there and welcome to Catchment of Resources. This is Vivero. This is part 6 of the series on OpenFAST. Here we are going to be looking at building and running Fast Farm. Fast Farm is one of the modules in OpenFAST used for the design and visualization of wind farms. We'll do a quick preview of how to build and run OpenFAST, although we are not going to be focusing on what has been done in part 1 and 2 of this video series. We are going to highlight what is going to be done and how to generate it on CMake. We are also going to look at the prerequisites for running Fast Farm, because Fast Farm requires a higher framework in terms of installation and prerequisites. Also, we'll look briefly at how to install MKL and building a Fast Farm. Lastly, we are going to run Fast Farm. So a preview of some of the ways to build and run OpenFAST. Like we said in part 1, you can use the downloaded precompiled binaries from the GitHub website. Part 2, we looked at how to build it yourself. That's, you use the source code and build it using Visual Studio. Although we did it just on Windows, it's possible to do it on other computer systems. Then lastly, for the case of CMake, generating OpenFAST binaries using CMake, we have not really touched upon it, but you can see it in the documentation as 2.2.4 and 2.2.6. So basically, CMake can be generated either using the command line, or you can use the CMake graphical user interface, which can be shown here. So there's a txt file that you actually look at a list of commands of different information which is generated using this. So you select where the instruction file is, and you also select where you want the binaries to be generated to. Following the instructions in the documentation, it will be much easier to carry out this generation using CMake. So just in case you run into some errors while trying to run Fast or fast.farm using CMake, this is just a quick highlight on the prerequisites. While we're building Fast or OpenFAST using Visual Studio, there are some prerequisites we actually had to download so we can use the frameworks to ensure the full installation of OpenFAST. We did the downloading of an installation of Intel 1API based toolkit as well as Intel 1API HPC toolkit. If you had to try to generate the binaries using CMake, you may run into some errors like what you have at the right, where it talks about MKL. MKL is basically the mathcanal libraries. There are some additional requirements. So in order for this framework to be installed, you need to actually go to the website, the Intel website, in order to download it, similar to what we did in previous videos. So here is an example of where you can download the Intel 1 MKL. So once it's downloaded, you can actually install it straight away. So after installing the MKL from the Intel website, you can then go ahead to build Fast Farm. In this case, we are using Visual Studio to build Fast Farm. So you navigate to the Fast Farm solution file, then you open it with Visual Studio as before. Afterwards, you select your solution configuration, which is release_openmp. And the solution platform, which will be x64 or 32, depending on your system configuration. So once Fast Farm has been built, you can then go ahead to copy one of the DISCON files and place it in the 5 megawatt baseline. In this case, for the Fast Farm platform, not for what you did in OpenFAST. So on that Fast Farm, you also have a folder for the 5 megawatt baseline wind turbine input data. So in that server data file, you are going to place this copied DISCON file and rename it to DISCON_WT1, which stands for wind turbine 1. So as was explained in part 1, you then run the files using the command prompt. In this case, you are using the fast.farm, which we just generated, the fast.farm_x64omp executable, as well as the .fstf file. Here you are going to run the .fstf file, not the .fst file, because the .fst file is basically just the regular wind turbine, but the .fstf file is for the wind farm itself. So you see here, initially when I ran it, it showed me some errors that it cannot find DISCON underscore WT2. So when I copied the discount file, I renamed it again to WT2. And when I ran the program again, there was no error and it terminated normally. So that's basically what needs to be done in order to run fast farm. In a subsequent video, we are going to look at how to visualize this wind farm using OpenFAST. Thank you for watching this video. This is Catmint of Resources, where we create for better living.